Stand. Oh, no. Remains standing as we start the Holy Mass in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today, the first Friday of the month of December, the last month of the year,
but so long as in
the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory
to you, O Lord. The four seasons of the year, which are winter, spring, summer, fall. Now there are also four seasons of the church. Okay, then we also prepare for his birth on Christmas Day. Christmas is a wonderful time of the year. It's a time for what do you do? What do you do to your friends? What do you send them? What do you give them? And it gifts. All right. That's a nice. Giving gifts to our friends. Who started the idea of giving? Yes? Jesus. Okay. Very good. Jesus gave himself. That is the message of Christmas. So we put that in our heart.
Lord, hear our prayer. That the church may be a credible witness to the gospel and be a sure guide to peace and solitude. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those in government offices be men and women of principles and integrity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That like the two blind men, may we have firm confidence in Jesus and follow him on the path of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are suffering in failing eyesight or blindness may overcome their difficulties and find total healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our deceased relatives and friends may be granted perpetual light and eternal rest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father in heaven, fill us with your love and dispel the darkness from our lives so that we may work in the light of Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now be seated as we prepare our...
Thank you.
sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. If the Lord has set the sacrifice in your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for the good of the Holy Lord's church, receive, O Lord, these offerings we bring with you in commemoration of St. Francis Xavier, and grant that as he journeyed to distant lands out of longing for the salvation of souls, so we too, bearing effective witness to the gospel, may with our brothers and sisters eagerly hasten towards you. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, your Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. Through Christ our Lord, we assure at his first coming the holiness of human flesh, and so fulfill the design you formed long ago and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. Then, when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we too watch for that day. May inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Through him and with him and in him,
us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, grace to be ground peace in our days. That by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, to God in our sins, but to the faith of your church, and grace to grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer to one another the peace of Christ.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
In addition to celebrating the spirit of giving, the season of Advent, we also celebrate, and as Father said, this is the last month of the year, we also celebrate the end of the first trimester, the beginning of the second trimester in the academic year, a chance for a new beginning. Same way we celebrate Advent, we have a chance to celebrate, you know, what we've achieved and celebrate what we have yet to achieve. So what I would like to do is begin this year with this Advent season, with this First Friday Mass, is to celebrate those students who achieved academic excellence in the first trimester. I've asked the homeroom teachers, this is for grades 8 through 4, and I've asked the homeroom teachers to make sure that the students knew if they were chosen for the honor. That required not only academic excellence, but also, you know, in the spirit of giving, setting the right example. So being a model of exemplary behavior as well. So I wish to really commend those students, and I'd like to call you up for a photo. And Ms. Elliman, who's been videotaping this mass for our pre-K and kindergarten students who aren't able to join us at this time, they'll have a chance to see the recognition and the celebration that we're participating in today. So as I call you up by grade, by name, but by grade, I'm going to call you up and ask you to come up, and we're going to line up in front and take a...
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father,
Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.
Who in peace glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.